you have created a VPN tunnel to access your database securely, and then you have replicated every routing details using your cloud router. Hello friends, welcome to ITK Funday, your own channel where we make IT interesting for everyone. So in this video, we will understand about virtual private cloud. VPC is the fundamental platform on top of which all the various cloud platforms or cloud technologies are running today. VPC, which is virtual private cloud, provides us access to all the cloud infrastructure and networks. This is a common concept which is used across different cloud technologies, but we will understand it in relation with Google Cloud Platform. We will understand what is a VPC, we will understand its features and what different components we have in Google Cloud Platform VPC product, and then at the end we will take a use case and we will try to understand it through a real example. So without wasting any more time, let's get started.
Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon.
So let's understand what is a VPC. Suppose there is a new startup company, XYZ, who's trying to establish its office in a city, and it's this company wants to set up its IT data center within the premises. So what they will do, they will start with the network planning, they will start with understanding what kind of network requirements they have, and then maybe they will have a data center which in which they will deploy all the servers which are needed and all the network requirements, firewall rules, whatever is required will be put into this particular company's premises, and all this will be done with a proper network planning, and actual hardware will be set up. So you will have physical LANs, you will have physical routers which will be set up, routing tables will be set up, firewall rules will be set up, physical machines which will be deployed here. So take for example that this is done all manually, okay, and you have to first do the planning and then you have to also do the work on the ground. Now suppose if that same company wants that they want to have a lean startup and they want to leverage cloud technology to set up its all IT infrastructure. So in the same manner how we did the network planning for on-prem, in the same manner it will be done on the cloud as well. But there will be a big difference. In cloud, you will not be touching the physical infrastructure or physical networks at all. In cloud, you will just have a software front end wherein you will define what you want and rest all will be taken care by your cloud provider. So this is called as software defined network. So VPC is nothing but a software defined network. What is software defined network? As I explained you, you will have a front end, you will have a GUI, or you will program your whole network infrastructure through a front end application, okay? But you don't have to do it manually going into the data center. That will be done automatically and you will be a part of the huge infrastructure. In example, in case of Google Cloud Platform, you will be using the same infrastructure which is used by Google Search, YouTube, and all the different Google products. And then that particular network is globally accessible. What is meant by globally? If you want, you can watch my video, previous video, where I explained that every cloud component, Google Cloud component, can be categorized as a global, regional, or a zonal resource. So your network, your VPC, which is virtual private cloud, is your global resource. So friends, now let's understand the key components of Google Cloud VPC and also some important features which we should be aware of. Cloud VPN, cloud router, firewall, NAT, subnets, IP ranges, VPC peering, cloud interconnect and flow logs. VPN, as you can understand, is used to establish connectivity with your on-prem data center. Suppose if you want to connect one server from your data center to to your cloud VM, then you can use VPN, and VPN will establish a tunnel over the internet to provide that connectivity. Obviously, it will have if you need higher bandwidth or higher throughput, then VPN might not be a better option for you, because VPN underline uses IPsec protocol, And this particular protocol is a bit heavy in nature because it has additional encryption headers, which slows down the data transfer rate. So that's why if you have needs of more than 10 Gbps throughput, then instead of using Cloud VPN to connect from your on-prem to your Google Cloud network, you should use Cloud Interconnect, which is a direct virtual LAN which will be established between your data center and Google Cloud. And this is a very good option. It has two different types: dedicated interconnect, where a Google Cloud point of presence, you will connect directly to a Google Cloud point of presence location through direct connection, which is called as dedicated interconnect. And the other one is partner interconnect, wherein if you do not have a nearby point of presence for Google Cloud platform or Google Cloud data center, then you will go through a partner, a verified partner of Google Cloud. Cloud router, don't take it as a physical router. It is not a physical router. Cloud router is kind of an object. Everything which you see on Google Cloud is treated as an object. So Cloud router tries to understand the routing which has been performed in your on-prem environment and tries to mimic that or automate that using BGP protocol, which is also called as dynamic routing. But still, you can also have static routing, wherein you decide and you define your own network. Firewall, again, is controlled under VPC, Virtual Private Cloud, but then you will define actual firewall rules on your VMs. But yes, you can enable or disable, firewall rules in your overall VPC. So by default, you can have, by default, you have one ingress rule and one egress rule. Ingress means incoming rule and egress means outgoing rule. So you can define your firewall rules. You can control it from your VPC level. But then at your VM level, you will have your specific firewall rules established. NAT is again network address translation, again a similar service which we use to convert a private IP address which is there within your premises. If you want to go over the internet, you use network address translation. Similar service is provided by this NAT service of VPC. Subnets, now again, this is a very important topic, because by default you have three different modes when you create a VPC. So in your VPC, you will have your default mode, your auto mode, and your custom mode. So by default mode is pretty much your auto mode. By default, if you choose this, automatically you don't have to do anything. You will have predefined VPC and predefined subnets in different regions of that particular VPC network. So you don't have to do anything. You will get predefined subnet ranges, and in those subnet ranges you can deploy your network. But there is a risk, because whatever subnet ranges are defined automatically might overlap with your on-prem network ranges. So suppose you have your on-prem network being migrated into Google Cloud, and if you simply select default or auto, it might happen that your subnet ranges and your IP address ranges might overlap each other. So this should be used in development or non-production environment, but Google recommends that when you are going on to a production environment, you should always choose custom. And custom is pretty much defining yourself what you want on your VPC. So in custom, you will define your subnet range, and that would be a much safer option. So the first address is your network address. The second address in your subnet range is your gateway. Your second to last address, IP address in your subnet range, is reserved by Google for any future use. And your last network address in your subnet range is your broadcast IP. I have explained subnetting in a different video, so if you want to understand it, you can check that video separately. IP ranges, again, you will have by default a primary IP range, but then you can also have a secondary IP range, which is an alias IP range, which you can utilize under a VPC. And this is very important, or might be very useful, when you are doing deploying containerized applications, wherein your certain pods could run on your primary IP range, but then in case of any failures, you might have certain pods running on your secondary IP range. So this is optional, but yes, you can have your secondary IP ranges as well. So VPC pairing, I will discuss at a later point. I will leave it for now. Cloud interconnect, I have explained it already that if you are not, you know, if you are not happy with your VPN bandwidth, you want more bandwidth, then you should go for cloud interconnect. Flow logs is very important. So this is to enable monitoring on your overall VPC network. And once you enable flow logs, you will be able to see these logs in your stack driver. Stack driver is a component, is a product which is a part of Google Cloud Platform for your overall monitoring. So these are some very important components. So now let's understand some important features of VPC. As I said, VPC is a global resource, which means that you can have a shared VPC, and that particular shared VPC can be accessed by multiple projects. So you can have a host project, and if you do not understand what is a project, then you can check my previous video. So everything which you encapsulate in a Google Cloud Platform, whatever you build, ultimately your project is the ultimate container in which everything gets defined. Okay, be it your VM, be it your, so your billing, whatever you are utilizing will be decided in context with that particular project. Okay, so now why VPC is unique? Because VPC can span across, okay, across zones, across regions, because it's a global resource. But there could be that you do not want to share your network at all. You might have a company A which supplies some data to company B. Now both these companies are completely different, their organization is different, their structure is different, and there is no commonality between that, but both exist within Google Cloud. But one has a VPC network A, another has a VPC network B. So in that case, you can have VPC pairing. And from the speed perspective, from bandwidth perspective, it will be as good as having a shared VPC. Now you will ask how it can be possible, because shared VPC should be much faster. But underlying both these concepts, be it a shared VPC or be it VPC pairing, you are actually using the underlying infrastructure of Google. So that's why both are equivalent, and be it VPC pairing or a shared VPC, you get optimal and the best performance. One very important feature is that in case you want to increase your IP address space for a subnet, so in that case you don't need to shut down your machines at all. It can be done on the fly, which is a very strong feature. Now another very important feature is, while all these will be defined by you, you will definitely want to access the default managed services and APIs which are given by Google. So suppose in your VPC you deploy a virtual machine. Now that particular virtual machine wants to connect to a Google Cloud Storage, and in Google Cloud Storage there are certain files which needs to be accessed. Now in that case, you can directly access the Google Cloud Storage bucket. You don't have to go through the internet. So that is also a very strong thing, that your VPC can internally access all the common Google APIs, which are not a part of your VPC. Okay, these are managed services, okay, given by Google, ready-made, ready to use, but you can still directly use it. So your VPC is secure, customizable, and very, very robust. Okay, so this is some key components of VPC, and these are some features of your virtual private cloud. Now we will quickly understand it through a use case. So now let's take an example. In this example, company XYZ has a monolith application deployed on its on-prem data center. And the requirement is that, this is a very simple application wherein the application server connects with the DB server. These two are in two different subnetworks. And then there is a router NAT gateway through which you are accessing the internet. And there is a firewall rule which only allows HTTPS traffic on a certain port, for example, 8080. Okay, this is one of the very basic designs I am explaining by, you can have different solutions to one particular requirement, okay? But my objective is to show you that how we can replicate this onto Google Cloud VPC, okay? So suppose the company now wants that their application layer needs to go onto the cloud. So the requirement is that migrate the application layer on the cloud, but the DB layer should continue to be on-prem. And this is being a legacy application is only running on a single node on the production environment. So they want that there should be a failover replica of this particular application, so that by chance, if something happens to this particular application server on the cloud, there has to be a fallback option. Okay. So with this requirement, now we will try to see how we will try to achieve this requirement using a VPC setup on Google Cloud. So friends, now I have tried transforming this requirement into a Google Cloud VPC network. And by no means I am saying that this is the best design. There could be better ways to achieve it, but this is just to explain you how we could achieve it, what is the basic concept. So I have not dwelt too much on the best of the designs, but it will definitely give you an idea of how you could go about migrating your applications onto Google Cloud. So what was our requirement? Our requirement was that our front-end application need to be migrated on cloud, and then there needs to be increased availability of that particular application. There needs to be a failover node which should be available in case the primary node goes down. So the first thing which you need to do is to set up your VPC, set up all your routing, your VPN tunnel, because through your VPN tunnel over the internet, because you do not need high throughput, as I told you earlier, it does not have high throughput. So over the internet, even with IPsec protocol and a bit of overhead, still a VPN connection could work well in your scenario. So you will establish a VPN tunnel between your database layer. So now only your database layer is on-prem and rest all has been moved into cloud. Now here is your VPN, here is your cloud VPN, the connectivity established, all the routing details which are there has been taken over by the cloud router, and it will replicate it automatically, and then the firewall also will be copied over, whatever firewall rules would be there, like suppose if the port is only 1521, port needs to be accessed on this DB server, that will go as well. Now in this, what we have done is we have created a shared VPC, as I told you, because this will be a global resource. And within that, this shared VPC, we have created two different subnetworks. With one subnetwork, we have connected one particular region, and within that particular region, we have deployed a virtual machine, which will be our primary node of the application. And on the region 2, we have created it on top of subnet 2, which is a second subnetwork, which we have created under a shared VPC. And here we have put our failover node. And this is there on region 1 and this is present on region 2. And then I missed to tell you that also there is one more component on VPC, which is load balancers. Okay, so load balancer can be set up, and this load balancer will always point to the primary and the failover node, and then from your shared VPC, the internet connection can be accessed as well. So now what you have done here is that you have created one shared VPC, and then you have distributed your application, primary application on one region and secondary failover node on the second region. So you have increased availability of your node. You have created a VPN tunnel to access your database securely. And then you have replicated every routing details using your cloud router. So everything which you are doing here right now is pretty much what you do when you set up a VPC network. Now it is a very simplistic overview, and maybe this design is not perfect. There could be better ways of doing it, but the whole essence of showing this to you is that this is exactly what you will do when you will create it on the Google Cloud platform. Now, I am not doing any demo of this on the laptop, but it is self-explanatory. I will share the links of some very good tutorials which you can follow along, and there you can have and go into much more detail. This whole VPC topic is quite vast, but I have tried to consolidate and summarize it to the best extent possible. But now from here on, it's your journey. You need to explore more and try to take different use cases and try to experiment. As I have told you earlier, there is a $300 credit which you get for a free tier Google Cloud environment. with just putting your credit card or debit card. But now you only get 90 days to utilize that. So maybe from your normal Gmail ID you can create it. Because unless you don't do all this by your hands-on exercise, you will not get confident about it. I am also doing the same, so I am recommending you that you also should go and try to set up some dummy network and try to understand. So friends, we have now come to an end of this whole tutorial. I hope you now understand what is VPC, what is a VPC network, and how we can correlate it with a normal network, legacy network, which we find in our data center, and how we can migrate our applications to Google Cloud VPC. So friends, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit the thumbs up button. Hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you exactly know when I upload my next video. I'll continue with my Google Cloud Platform series. So I'll continue to add more and more lessons and fundamentals of Google Cloud Platform. I continue to get all your comments and I really, really appreciate all your feedback, advices, support, and some good feedback. And I try to take it into account whenever I'm trying to upload or create my new lecture. So thank you so much. Please let me know in the comment section what you liked about this video, what you would want to learn next on Google Cloud, and I'll try to make a video on the same. So until next time, keep hustling. Bye for now.